all of your lesson. In your practical copy, on page number 89, in your practical copy, on page number 89, you see like this projects. Okay, you can select any project, right? Any project. Here the projects given are to study the presence of oxalate iron content in guava fruits, amrut, at different stages of ripening. Then to study, project two, to study the quantity of casein present in different samples of milk, cow milk, buffalo milk, goat milk, sheep milk. Preparation of soybean milk and its comparison with the natural milk with respect to curd formation, effect of temperature and taste. This you can do at home. For to take soybean milk, this normally I do at home. Every week I do. So soybean you soak in water and keep it overnight and grind it with a little bit of water. You grind it and you squeeze that milk, putting in a challni or putting in a chunni. That is chunni, chunni cloth is the best. So that you can squeeze that milk. This you can do at home, no problem. That is project 3. And you can make soya paneer also out of that. Soya paneer, it's very good for health. Soya paneer, it contains a lot of protein. So many projects are given. Project 4 is that you cannot do at home. This project 3 you can do easily. So you see which one you can do at home. That you can do. Matter is given here. You can copy it from here. You can copy it from here. Then these observation tables are also given. So here 8 projects are given. You can either select one from these projects, or if it is not possible for you, then you can write chapter 1 to 4, means any one of the chapter from 1 to 4. Solid state, solutions, electrochemistry, chemical kinetics. Either one project from here with observation columns and all, or you can write one chapter. Write one chapter means if it is not possible for you to make this project during this COVID season. And that project is to be written like this. Chemistry project, name, class, roll number, we will give you roll number. Roll number, your board roll number, you have to write here. Your board roll number. Then the student has written a solid state. Okay. Then index. Index is to be written like this. On pages, page number. Only write the page number. Then certificate. Here I have to sign. This is the page in which I have to sign. The matter is, this is to certify that you have to write that. This is to certify that Nakul Sanadia of class 12, means your name, Muhammad Aris, Edo Muhammad Aris of class 12 has completed his project on the topic, solid state, whatever it is, on the topic, satisfactorily. This project has been completed and submitted to ma'am Shaini. So this Nakul Sanadia name, board roll number, class 12A, like this. Okay, here I have to sign. So matter is, this is to certify that Nakul Sanadia of class 12 has completed his project on the topic. Then you write your topic satisfactorily. This project has been completed and submitted to ma'am Shaini. Then acknowledgement. This acknowledgement. Acknowledgements you can take from net, any format you can take it from net. Now the topic, that is your project. All right, what you are projecting. Here the student has given, shown these diagrams and all these things, packing efficiency and all. And here finally, on the last page, the external examiner will be signed. On the last page, external examiner will be signed. Okay, 5-6 pages you can give and submit this in these type of files. Okay, these types of files. Like this, these types of file, L folder, like that. Then coming to our copywriting. Copywriting, last year's your copies are here, class 11th copies are here. 12th copy you must be having. In that, you have to write that KMNO for iteration that you have done last year, that is actually of 12th class. I made you to write in, do in class 11th, that is of class 12th. By chance I made you to do that. So that you can write in this copy. So that is the experiment, that is the titration experiment you can write. And after that, you write salt analysis. Salt analysis. First, you write scheme for analysis. Salt analysis is starting with scheme for analysis. Scheme for analysis means, by what scheme you are using to analyze this thing. After writing the scheme, then you can start your salt analysis. That is analysis of simple salt. Analysis of simple salt. You write five salts. Five salts. One is lead acetate, copper sulfate, then aluminium, Al2SO4+. Aluminium sulfate. This is of analysis, that is first group analysis, not the periodic table. This is of first group, this is of second group of analysis, not that of periodic table. This is of third aluminium sulfate, that is aluminium A3+ third group, included in third group. Copper sulfate plus U2+ is included in second group. Lead acetate Pb2+, that is the basic radical part, cationic part. Then fourth group, zinc nitrate or zinc sulfate. Zinc nitrate or zinc sulfate. Zn2+. Right, fifth group, barium chloride. Barium chloride, Ba2+. Right, then one from zero group. Ammonium nitrate. Ammonium nitrate. Acid radicals are nitrate, acetate, sulfate, chloride. Alright? So these, for these salts, you write from zero group, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all together 6, ammonium nitrate, lead acetate, copper sulfate, aluminum sulfate, zinc sulfate. Alright? Then barium chloride. Okay. So these salts you write. First preliminary experiments. These salts you write when you come. We will be doing this. When you come, we will be doing this. So the method of writing. The method of writing under what it is. This you copy.
Yes, ma'am.
These six salts you write one from zero group, then till fifth group. So the way of writing I'm going to give heading analysis of simple salt. Analysis of simple salt. That is heading salt number one. Okay, again GPL you have to write in a circle salt one. Salt one. During the exam also you have to write a salt number. You may be getting one packet and that packet will carry one number. On that packet, one number will be written. That number you have to write in the beginning of the salt analysis. Analysis of simple salt, Roman numeral, preliminary experiments. Preliminary experiments. That is A, color, color and appearance. Color and appearance. B. Solubility. Solubility. C. Flame test. Flame test. D. Action with NaOH. Action with NaOH. Solubility, this solubility in water, right? Color and appearance, solubility in water. Only soluble salts will be given to you. Then flame test, action with NaOH. Action of heat, I haven't included in this. Action of heat. Number two, analysis of acid radical. Analysis of acid radical. In this, you can write action with the dilute H2SO4, then its confirmatory test. So first one, testing, that is identification test, then confirmatory test. Identification A, identification test. Identification. Test. Then B, it's confirmatory. It's confirmatory. Confirm. confirmatory test. Okay, it's confirmatory test. Next, Roman numeral C. Roman numeral third. Roman numeral third. Analysis of basic right. Analysis of basic right. Analysis of basic right. Next, captaining part. Okay. In that intergroup separation, A, intergroup separation. Intergroup separation. B, identification. Identification test. C, confirmatory test. It's confirmatory test. It's confirmatory test. Then, Roman numeral 4, results. Roman numeral 4, results. Results. Result mein aisa likhna, the given salt contains. The given salt contains. Contains. So and so as acid radical, as acid radical, and so as basic radical, basic radical, basic radical. Okay. With that, that portion is over. Okay, this is of 8 marks. Previous titration is of 10 marks. Titration is of 10 marks. This is of 8 marks, right? Next, organic analysis, that is of 6 marks. Organic analysis of 6 marks. Now we are going to the organic analysis. So this you will be writing in 3-line column page. 3-line column page. Okay. The first experiment, that is titration, you will be writing in the front normal line page, right? We are going to write only one experiment over there, that is titration, KMNO4 titration. Then after that, if we have time, then we will be doing and writing. So keep some time there in January to write. If you are able to do some more experiments, we will be writing that time. Without doing, it is not scientific. Then writing. So these things you write it and keep. Of course, these things we will be doing. This you have already done last year also. Next, organic analysis. That is for the 6 marks. Right? Then 4 marks for this record and 4 marks for those wild. Alright. Organic analysis. Organic experiments. Organic experiments. So then you do distinguish between distinguish between phenol and carboxylic acid. Write and keep A. Distinguish between phenol and carboxylic acid. So you make two columns. And one you write phenol and one you write carboxylic benzoic acid. Same test you should do for both. One should be giving positive test and one should be giving negative test. So you write here what all things you are adding. So you write this equation. And the observation. So here you can report with NaHCO3. So to this we are adding NaHCO3. This will not give the evolution of carbon dioxide. Here it will be giving the evolution of carbon dioxide. So equation. First you do what all things you are adding. One sentence. It's what you are doing. Means to the given substance. We have added NaHCO3 and heated. In this rescue, we got the evolution of carbon dioxide. The test tube in which this evolution of carbon dioxide is observed, that test tube contains carboxylic acid. So you will be given two beakers A and B. One beaker will be marked A and the other beaker will be marked B. One will contain phenol, one will contain carboxylic acid. We don't know which one is which. Which is which? For that, you are taking little bit of substance from beaker A to one test tube and little bit of substance from beaker B to another test tube. To both these test tubes, you are adding NaHCO3. The one and heat. The one which gives the evolution of carbon dioxide is carboxylic acid. So here you can write beaker A, beaker B. Alright, then we say beaker B contains so and so. Yeah, beaker A contains so and so. So distinguish between phenol and carboxylic acid. Next, distinguish between aldehyde and ketone. So again two beakers, beaker A and beaker B. Similar way, you can write. Beaker A, beaker B. So beaker A, you are adding what? Collins reagents, ammonia and silver nitrate solution, and heat it in a water bath. Water bath is nothing. A vessel which contains water that is kept on the fire so that it always boils. In that boiling water, you are putting the test tube, not direct heating. Organic compounds should not be heated directly because many are volatile. The vapors come out and that will be catching. The vapors which are coming out will be coming to flame and this will catch fire. So organic compounds are to be heated in a water bath. Water bath means a vessel contains water and it is heated. It is always heated. एक भगोना, एक vessel. Sand bath you must have seen. That mungfali wala while roasting these mungfali, these peanuts, to give very high heat. What he does? He takes sand in this vessel and he heat the sand. The sand will be heated to very high temperature. So this mungfali or peanuts will be getting very high heat. So that is a sand bath. This is a water bath. Okay. So aldehyde and ketone. You can write toluene CH. What is toluene CH? Ammonium and silver nitrate solution. Ag, NH3 twice plus. Ammonium silver nitrate solution, you add in both. The one and heat, the water bath, the one which gives silver mirror in the inner parts of the test tube is the aldehyde. Ketones will not be oxidized by toluene CH. Toluene CH is a mild oxidizing agent. So this thing is between aldehyde and so this is the way of the question. Now, after that, you write the functional group analysis. Functional group analysis. Heading. Functional group analysis. Two tests for each functional group. Number one, that is alcoholic group. Alcoholic group. Two tests that is given in your book. Stearic ammonium nitrate test, then metallic sodium test. Metallic sodium. Here on page number 39, your test for unsaturations is starting at test for unsaturation. That also you can write test for unsaturation. It's double bond or triple bond. Then alcoholic test for alcoholic sodium metal test means Sandel test. Two tests for each alcoholic group. Then test for phenolic group. Two tests. Test for phenolic group. Then test for aldehyde group. Test for aldehyde group, toluene reagent and filling solution. Test for ketonic group. Test for ketonic group. Two tests. Test for ketonic group. Test for carboxylic acid group, two tests, and test for amino groups. These tests you can take it from here. Two tests each, only that. It's two tests. Okay. After that only you write distribution. Okay. After that, you do examination format, that is distribution. Okay. Thank you. Any doubt anybody has got, you can ask afterwards also. So you start writing. When you come for pre-board examination, you bring this copy and project. Okay, when you come for pre-board examination in January, you can bring this copy and project both. Thank you.